Gallagher. I agree that she's a married woman, but why then was not she with her husband all night? You think that she could have spent the night with
her? No, please, please, JR. How
is possible, don't you think?
Kamingo was being treated in a hospital.
He was released, though.
Well, it's possible that she was trying to nurse him back to health. I don't know.
But Benoit stuck on the way, the Raven Wolverine on Bradshaw, and Bradshaw himself is tougher than a $2 steak.
You know, when somebody has a concussion, you can't leave them alone. You can't let them go to sleep or anything like that. You have to keep them awake.
So you're saying they slept together?
No, you can't. You can't go to sleep.
Yes.
They didn't sleep together.
JR.
They were together. What do you know? You're not telling me.
Please, JR, watch your language. I know it's late night, but come on.
Quite a collision there in mid-ring with Albert and Bradshaw. All I know is that Triple H is beside himself. He's been out by the entrance area most of the afternoon waiting on his wife to arrive, and that has yet to happen.
I'm sure she'll be here.
And the thing about it is, if Stephanie's not here and Kurt Angle's not here, could they be together?
Man, you won't let it go.
Oh, what a takedown by Y2J, taking down this monstrous Albert. Rick on the outside handling test. It's Bradshaw and Benoit.
I'm telling you, JR, watch it. They could come. You watch the action, I watch Trish.
Well, good for you.
Oh, look at that. Oh, man, that's it.
Man, what a net breaker that was. One, two, and three, no. A wrong two count.
Look at Trish. I told you, I watch her.
Trish cannot believe it.
Trish is up.
And look at the strength of Albert. Oh, my God, Bradshaw. With that big boot right to the face. The double teams. The Lion Song. The victory.
Kane, with all the problems between you and your brother, The Undertaker, how are you going to be able to fully concentrate tonight in your WWF title match against The Rock?
It's a matter, Michael. Nervous, scared. What my brother tried to do was show the world what I am. What I have tried to hide my entire life. What you people wouldn't accept. The fact that I am and always have been a monster. Well, since the world won't accept me, I won't accept them. Since the world is afraid of me, I'm gonna give you something to be scared of. But the one thing that I would enjoy more than beating my normal brother to a bloody pulp is to beat the people's champion. Because then the monster will represent the people as WWF champion.
A wild scene at WWF New York. Rock tonight. Here on Raw, Commissioner Mick Foley says your challenge will be in the form of the big red monster Kane. After everything that you went through last night at SummerSlam, are you mentally as well as physically prepared for this contest?
Finally, The Rock has come back to Greensboro.
And not a moment too soon for these fans.
Kevin Kelly, let The Rock answer your question with a question of his own. Are you mentally as well as physically prepared to tickle the anus of a monkey?
What?
Rock, why do you always...
Why do you ask The Rock stupid questions? Why are you an ugly hermaphrodite? Nobody knows, Kevin Kelly. But what everybody does know is this, is last night at SummerSlam, The Rock went through a war. Last night at SummerSlam, The Rock went to hell and back. And last night at SummerSlam, The Rock is still WWF champion.
He got that right.
It was a war, no doubt about that.
And he's still the champ.
But for how much longer?
The monster's waiting.
And now on to tonight. After everything The Rock went through last night, tonight, The Rock has got to face 7 feet, 330 pounds of monster. Oh. Kane, you have the nerve to run your mouth and say that you're going to take what's most important to The Rock, the WWF title. And not only that, you're going to represent the people. Whoa. Well, make no mistake about it, Kane, there ain't but one. And The Rock means one man who represents the people. That's The Rock, the Brahma Bull, the same man who tonight is going to whoop your 7 foot burnt up candy ass all over Greensboro.
These fans are livid. They're ready.
If you smell it, what The Rock is cooking.
It's gonna be a war. The Rock, Kane, the WWE title. Let's get it on next. Momentum here. Oh,
there's a monster mash for you right there. Earl Hebner got mashed by The Rock. Thanks to the monster.
Fuck. No referee here. You can hear us in the back. Oh, yeah. No referee here. The spine buster by The Rock.
Oh, wait. This is it. The Rock has got Kane down, and he is fixing to deliver. Debunked electrifying move. Get up, ref. Here comes the people down.
The Rock delivered. He's got the cover, but the referee is down. There's no referee there to make the kill.
Get up, Earl. Here he comes.
Earl Hebner mashed in the corner. And The Rock trying to revive the record. Oh, my God, Kane's
up. Watch it, Rock. Oh, my God.
Kane's up. But the
choke slam.
The choke slam by Kane. That's going to be over. That's going to be over. He's got three. We got a new champion. The Rock and Kane. Kane can't believe it. Kane can taste the WWE title.
Oh, watch it. The monster is mad now. This is not going to be good.
Kane was a half a second away from defeating The Rock for the title.
And that might have been the wisest thing that The Rock could have done. Get defeated for the title. He shouldn't have kicked out, I think. He's got to suffer some. Oh, man. Wait a minute.
Undertaker. This could be a nightmare for The Rock.
Not a goal.
The top slam. Now The Rock bottom. Is that enough?
He got it.
Finally, finally, The Rock has defended successfully.
Here's your winner
WWE
and
title.
Still World Wrestling Federation champion, The Rock.
But what did it take, JR? Not one, not two, but three Rock bottoms plus a choke slam from The Undertaker to keep Kane down.
The Rock knows that he had Lady Luck on his side tonight.
And The Undertaker. Man, look at this.
The Rock knows everybody's coming for that WWE title. And we still don't know, King, the whereabouts of Stephanie McMahon Helmsley.
Rocky, you're lucky tonight. I guarantee you there won't be a rematch. Not if The Rock can help it.
The intensity continues to rise in the WWE. And the on The Rock, he's staring at The Undertaker.
Wait a minute.
And The Undertaker staring back. What a war! What a night! The SmackDown on The Rock!
Here to see this.
Well, who knows when we're going to see Shane McMahon, Karen. Shane McMahon, of course, pushed 50 feet off that scaffolding by Steve Blackman at SummerSlam in a hardcore championship match. And The Undertaker knocking Benoit out of the ring.
Drew, Shane is convalescing, and you had your doubts about where Stephanie was. You found out that Stephanie was at Shane's bedside in the hospital all night.
Well, at least that's what she's saying, King, and I guess we got to give her the benefit of the doubt. Her husband, Triple H, in a triple threat match later on tonight against Kurt Angle and Eddie Guerrero. And speaking of Triple H, we just saw him losing back in the locker room area, thanks in part to that rat, Kurt Angle, stirring the pot once again.
You're going to have to calm down. Your mother ever tell you can't say anything nice?
Benoit whipped into the ropes. Look out, Undertaker. Oh, my. Benoit's in trouble. Oh, blast across Benoit.
Oh, man. That's it.
Cover him, Undertaker. You'd be the number one contender. Pinfall or submission in this matchup. The only way to become number one contender. Chris Benoit.
The Undertaker wanted to give him that devastating choke slam.
And the Rabid Wolverine is about to go for the win.
Title.
commentator table.
Well, The Rock will say this. He has to agree with Triple H on one thing. Mick Foley has been hit in the head one too many times with chairs because The Rock is a WWF champion, not Triple H.
Last time we checked, you were. I told you Foley's kind of an idiot. Believe it. What are you doing out here, Rock?
Well, The Rock obviously is out here to see Chris Benoit and Kane hopefully beat each other's brains in.
Both men want a shot at the WWF title. And certainly, ladies and gentlemen, last Thursday night on SmackDown, it was King getting Chris Benoit disqualified in a number one contenders match, King, Benoit and The Undertaker.
Yeah, Rock, you saw this. You saw what happened last Thursday.
Yeah, The Rock saw it. You're about to see exactly what The Rock thought of it, too.
The Rock laying a SmackDown on Chris Benoit.
Well, what were you doing there, Rock? Sort of returning the favor that The Undertaker did for you a while back?
Well, The Rock obviously doesn't forget a damn thing. Returning the favor, The Rock wouldn't say that. The Rock went in there and he did the right thing.
There you go, doing the right thing, JR. Oh,
this is for the number one contender for the WWE title. The WWE champion, The Rock, is here at ringside. It's going to be Chris Benoit and the Big Red Destruction Machine.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it's to determine the number one contender for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Making his way in the ring, weighing in at 326 pounds, Kane.
I'm going to tell you something, Rock. This guy can't give me the creeps. You gotta hope that you don't have to face him. You don't want to be in the ring with somebody. What do you think his face looks like?
Well, the fact of the matter is this. Is Kane 7 feet? Yes. Is he 350 pounds? Yes. Is he damn near unstoppable? Yes. But does his face look like your candy ass? Yes.
What? His face looks like my ass? Oh, boy.
Kane and Benoit for the number one contender, the WWE champion, The Rock, here at ringside. The winner of this match will move right into the number one contender slot and be in line for a chance to meet The Rock for the WWE title.
Wait a minute, Rock, my ass don't look that bad. It's not all burned and scarred.
Go for the cover, and Benoit will kick out early.
Well, if you really want to know what Kane's face looks like, I'll tell you what. It looks like an orangutan went ahead. It looks like an orangutan went ahead and took off Kane's mask, squatted, took a crap, lit that sumbitch on fire, and stomped it out with some football shoes.
Oh, my God.
Rather graphic, isn't it?
Yeah.
And yeah, look at this power of Kane. Close to 7 feet tall. Kane. He's manhandling Benoit. Benoit's got a great shot at taking Kane down in the ring. And now Kane pointing right toward The Rock.
Don't talk your trash to The Rock. No doubt, Kane is a monster. And you look at Chris Benoit. Chris Benoit proved to The Rock that he's a machine, that he keeps coming, keeps coming, keeps coming.
Well, you know, and Chris Benoit, he actually holds a victory over you, Rock. He was actually announced as the WWF champion one time. Would you rather face Benoit?
Well, the fact that the match continued and The Rock still did what he had to do and laid the smackdown on his candy ass.
Uh-oh. Benoit able to free himself.
Oh.
Looked like Kane might have been looking for that tombstone.
Oh, yeah. Boom.
Beautiful belly-to-back suplex. And there's a near fall.
Chris Benoit proved to The Rock that he can take it. He proved to The Rock that he can go toe-to-toe with The Rock. But what's more important than that is The Rock proved that he can whip Chris Benoit's ass with a bullet of post.
You won't knock another one of his teeth out, will you?
Nice suplex by Benoit. Benoit has the edge as far as pure wrestling is concerned.
Nope.
It breaks down into a fight. I got to throw my hat into Kane.
I think Benoit has the edge when it comes down to pure wrestling over anybody. Oh, my gosh!
Benoit, the driving headbutt off the top. Almost, he's addled himself.
Such a match of brother, Chris Benoit.
Oh, he's coming over here. Don't jump over here. Uh-oh.
Benoit. Turn his back on Kane, and you don't do that.
Look at this.
Good God, look at the power.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Right on his head.
Benoit landed right on his head.
That's what Kane.
That was an impaler.
I'm telling you, that probably put a smile on that smeared up face of Kane. He's demented. Look out.
Kane, that sadistic streak, there's no doubt about it, but the same can be said for Benoit's cool-heartedness. Kane, the right hand. Beating down the Chris Benoit, the match for the number one contendership underway here in Rupp Arena, Lexington, Kentucky.
Come on, Kane
rolled back in long enough to break the count.
Rock, I think both of these guys are trying to send a message straight to you. They both want your title. Look out.
Oh, what do you want? Some of The Rock. We'll trust The Rock on this. Well, bring it. Bring it. Go ahead and bring it, you no-tooth bitch.
What?
Oh,
look out. Oh, Kane
catching Benoit from behind.
Come back, Rock.
That could write The Rock thought. That Jabroni comes over here and he talks trash to The Rock.
Hey, look out!
Kane. Wait a minute, the rock by the throat. Hey, Kane's got the rock by the throat. Oh, and a right hand on the dip. They got it from behind. Kane Benoit in the steel chair. The referee's going to call for the bell. Down goes Benoit. Look at this. My God, it's chaotic out here. Oh, no. Rock bottom. The rock bottom on the monster. Contender slot's gonna have to be decided on another place and another time.
We got both the so-called number one contenders laid out right here at ringside.
Tag team table match around the corner.
Need to become the WWF champion. I will go through anything. I will destroy who I have to.
There's a cover.
I will eliminate whoever I have to, whether it's The Undertaker, whether it's The Rock, whether it's Kurt Angle, Triple H, or Chris Benoit, it doesn't matter.
Well, the Hardys and Lita certainly would love to be in The Undertaker and The Rock's shoes tonight, meeting Edge and Christian for the tag team titles. That was not to be, thanks to our fan-friendly commissioner, Mick Foley, who made this match earlier today. Edge and Christian did everything they could to limber tail out of it, but it didn't work. And here we are. Oh, my God, what a DDT! Oh my God, that's gotta be off. There's a cover. And Christian made sure the three didn't go down. Kane, some would say that you will end careers to become WWF champion again. End careers. Oh, what a spear by Ed, taking down the American badass, The Undertaker.
Do you know what Kane is, Jim?
Well, I have obviously not to the level that you do.
You don't. But I'll tell you what pain is. Pain can become your friend because it's the thing that lets you know that you're alive.
I've never looked at it that way, that pain can be my friend. I've never looked at it that way, quite frankly.
It's been my whole life.
Kane, you expect people to feel sorry for you?
No. I don't want anybody's sympathy.
Undertaker taking down Edge. I'm just asking the questions here. Can't find the mark on the elbow. The Undertaker going for it all there with that elbow. And Undertaker got some great elevation. And look now, Edge and Christian, the Undertaker planted in the champion's corner. WWF tag team titles on the line here. And the Rock, once he's back in there, has got to make the tag. We've got a double team here.
Of course, The Rock does. Everything is about The Rock.
Well, some might say that you're jealous of The Rock's success. Some may say you're jealous of your brother's popularity.
I'm not jealous of anybody.
Don't get excited about
it. I accept what I am.
And what are you? What are you, Kane? Come on. The Undertaker trying to fight back up. He'll never quit. Kane, you know that. Your brother will never quit as long as he can draw breath in his body.
He'll quit when I break him in half.
Well, you choke slamming through the floor of the ring, and he's still here.
Let me tell you something, Jim. Last Monday night on Raw, The Rock rock bottomed me, and I kicked out. Tonight, he rock bottomed me on the floor, and I'm still sitting here.
No one would ever doubt your toughness or your tenacity or your ability, for that matter. And we got another tag. Great teamwork by Edge and Christian. Singling out The Undertaker. And that's no small feat, I can tell you that. And a blatant choke. Edge and Christian did an outstanding job of teamwork, of tag teamwork, isolating The Undertaker and taking every shortcut they can to prevent The Rock from making a tag. We've seen people through tables. We've seen hoes in WWF New York. We've got a new Intercontinental Champion. What a night it has been, and now will we have new WWF Tag Team Champions. And the last thing in my life I thought would happen tonight was that the King would be injured and I would be joined by Kane. Not that I'm complaining, Kane. It's somewhat unusual. It's a very unique experience that I'm having. Rock wants that tag.
You want an experience, Jim?
No. Not that kind. I'm fine. I'm doing very well, thank you. I'm quite frankly happier here. I'm just concerned about the King, you know. Undertaker fighting back up. Ed's going to be concerned about the Undertaker's right hand because he's getting introduced to it. But look at the tenacity of Edge, cutting off the Undertaker's offense. And the Undertaker now going downstairs. Uh-oh, look out. Could be the last ride. Could be. Oh, wait a minute. Christian going for a ride. And oh, Edge with a drop kick right to the Undertaker's spine.
Good.
Do you enjoy seeing your brother hurt? You enjoy seeing your brother?
I enjoy it, especially when I do it.
And there's a cover here, and there's his feet in the ropes here. Referee Earl Hebner, our senior official, assigned this very important contest. Undertaker trying to pull his way back up, to fight his way back into this thing. Kane, you know your brother will never quit. Your brother will never stop fighting as long as he's breathing, as long as he can stay upright.
That's my point.
For double teaming. And there's Christian with a cup. Referee got a good look and got a two count. Right back on. Lateral press one more time. And another kick out by the Undertaker. With a quick tag. You've got to hand it to Edge and Christian. They are competing a very smart match here. And they were reluctant to get in it. But the Undertaker now trying to reinsert himself. And we'll both bend down. The Undertaker down, and so is Edge. And The Rock wants the tag. Christian got the tag. It's good to the Rock. The Rock took the world on Christian. This place erupted.
body with first Ben Wall, and then Kane on the outside. I can't believe this. Oh, The Rock. Edge and Christian, the luckiest men in the world. But what about The Rock and The Undertaker?
Oh, this is
okay.
I got pains in my side.
This man.
If he walked through Red Hook, he'd get mugged. Man, I can't even say on TV what happened to Red Hook. Yeah, he'd get mugged. He'd get mugged, beat up. Oh, listen to this.
What an ovation for the WWF champion.
What else is there? There we go. We're staying there for 10 minutes now. Yeah, he's electrifying.
Finally, The Rock has come back to Louisville.
At times you can't.
Isn't that the first time you used a line like that?
Laugh, laugh.
Now you two jabronis come out here running your mouths, showing your footage. We'll let The Rock get right to the point. Christian, did you beat The Rock on Monday night, 1, 2, 3? Yes, you did. Did you do it by yourself? No, you didn't. Not by a long shot. So let The Rock get right to the point. He wants you and you tonight.
The Rock wants the tag champions, both of them, tonight.
I guess he wants to get beat again.
Rock. Rock.
Well, the fans hope that Rock gets his wish. But who's The Rock's partner going to be?
Rock, I understand you may still be a little woozy from that double chair shot, the concerto, on Monday night, but that's never gonna happen.
Yeah, there's no way we're going to ruin our undefeated against The Rock in Kentucky streak, but wait. Christian, do you smell something? Rock, can you smell it? That's us, totally reeking of awesomeness.
I don't smell anything.
I smell it. I mean, exactly what they told me.
I smell something, but I can't say what it is on national television.
Yeah, I smell you too.
Let The Rock understand this. Did you two just say you reek of awesomeness? Is that your new catchphrase?
Well, yeah, you have to be.
It doesn't matter if that's your new catchphrase.
That's comedy.
Shut up. That ain't comedy. Shut up. That ain't funny.
Let The Rock give you a more accurate description, a more accurate catchphrase that fits the both of you. You two so totally, absolutely, unconditionally, positively reek of grade A Kentucky Derby horse.
Everybody laugh.
Oh, come on. You got to admit that was funny.
I ain't got to do nothing.
Well, Edge and Christian are talking about it, Taz. Well, they're talking about something.
Okay, Rock. You want your handicap match? Fine. But only under one condition. Instead of us tagging in and out, it's both of us in the ring at the same time.
Oh, boy. That's not quite fair.
Oh, I think that's perfectly fair. Perfectly.
Both tag partners in the ring at the same time. They're the tag team champions.
No problem.
Hey, wait a minute. Just hold on a second.
Now what are they talking about?
We got a plan, man. Relax.
The only way we'll get in the ring with you is if we're in the ring at the same time and your World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship is on the line.
What? I mean, there's no way. That's ridiculous. They both want to be champions, Taz.
Be done.
You two in the ring at the same time with The Rock? No problem. The Rock's WWF title on the line? No problem.
What? What's Rock thinking about?
But you two jabronis come out here running your mouths, talking about the past. Well, The Rock wants to talk about the future. Let The Rock take out his magical, invisible crystal ball. He sees Edge. He sees Christian. Good news, you're still WWF Tag Team Champions. But hold on, it's a little foggy. Ah, there it is. Clear as crystal. It's a picture of The Rock whipping both your monkey all over Louisville.
WWF title, you should go after the Intercontinental title because that would be totally immersed in Goldage.
Goldage?
Are you kidding me? A soda with my name on it? Now more than ever, sodas rule!
Hey! It's Rock! Rock attacking Edge and Christian from behind with a chair cannon!
Wait a minute, Rock, what are you doing?
These are the tag team champions and holding up! Christian the Vulture, once again, the scavenger lying in wait. But he walked into the Spinebuster. He walked into the Spinebuster.
And he's going to get this laid into him. The empty, most electrifying move in sports entertainment today. In the people's elbow, Michael. And we're going to see, we're going to see an elbow derailed, intercepted. Choke slam by Kane. Oh, my God. Champion. Kane could be the champion.
Count. Christian wants to be champion too in a low blow to Kane.
I know they're supposed to be partners, but it was Christian's match. He's the one that invited Kane to be the partner. Now we got it.
Cover. Now we got Christian and Kane.
Wait a minute. Look at this.
Oh, wait a minute. Christian tied over the top rope with authority by Kane.
I think Christian had the title won right there. Wait a minute. We got partners. You're right.
Four.
Hey. I haven't seen a relationship last year in the WWF longer. 10 minutes.
Well, I'll tell you what, Kane. You're right. It's not about partners. It's about the WWF title. And both of these men, like every superstar, wants to become champion.
Yeah, but both of these guys had an excellent opportunity.
Stay away from here.
Wait a minute, Kane. What are you doing?
Kane, what are you doing? Kane is ripping apart the announce table.
Come on, Kane. I told you, this guy is sick.
Kane, somebody's going to get hurt here. So, Kane, try to reason with the guy.
Kane, that's my...
I'm not going to try to raise your hand. He's on the table.
Our monitor.
Wait a minute. It's Edge. Edge coming down. Edge coming to his brother's aid. Edge coming to his brother's aid. And Kane. Kane. They're running away on Edge.
You got to admit, this reeks of braveness.
Braveness?
What do I mean for?
I think it reeks of stupidity.
What?
Hey. WWF title's on the line.
Christian speaking of the WWF title.
Christian with the championship in his hand. Right to his feet. Christian with the championship.
Watch him out.
Oh, get it. Rock bottom. Cover.
Edge. Look at this.
Wait a minute. Rock retains the title. Kane has no idea what happened. Kane has no idea what just happened.
I think Kane realized it now.
Well, Kane missed another opportunity to become champion.
Kane
just chokeslammed The Rock through the announce table.
the smart thing for
somebody
to do.
Anybody, you've got the guts, come on out here and face the music. If you smell...
What? Now, wait a minute. Stolen, but it was the Rock's car. Now just ask yourself, who has the most to gain by getting Stone Cold Steve Austin out of the World Wrestling Federation? If it walks like a duck, sometimes it really is a duck.
I guarantee you, King, Stone Cold Steve Austin is watching this broadcast. I know that for a fact. He's got to be living. Austin's got to be destroying furniture or whatever's around him right now.
What do you think of this, Stone Cold? The Rock ran you down.
Again, King, please, just please don't tell me it was the Rock that ran over Stone Cold last November. I mean,
well, just look, JR. That one little swerve of the wheel. One little thump with the bumper. Look where it's put the Rock. He's on top of the world. And you know what? Maybe it was an accident.
I just don't want to believe this. I mean, why, Rock? Man, oh, man. What a shot.
You!
Yeah.
It was you? You come out here, you walk down the people's ramp, to say that it was you all along? To say that you ran over Stone Cold Steve Austin? I say you've got some audacity putting out the rattlesnake, you cold-hearted, calloused son.
Uh-oh. I just can't believe this. Shot too. I mean, Rock's got to, he had to have some reason.
Listen, here we go.
The Rock admits it.
Did you hear
you
that?
You admit to running over Stone Cold.
The Rock admits that this is the biggest half-ass criminal investigation The Rock has ever seen.
Oh my God. Oh. Half what? What?
So, Rock, what you're saying is you didn't run over Stone Cold Steve Austin, did you?
I didn't think he did. Foley thought he did.
Not only is The Rock saying no, but considering that it's Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock says, oh, hell no!
See, JR, you always jump to conclusions.
You're the one that...
You see, The Rock gave his word to the cops that he didn't do it. The Rock gave his word to the people that he didn't do it. The Rock gave his word to Stone Cold himself that he didn't do it. And it doesn't matter whether or not the charges are dropped. It doesn't matter what's dropped. It doesn't matter if Austin's name is dropped. If your pants are dropped, the only thing that matters is that Austin go to Unforgiven. Find that son of a bitch who ran him over and deal with it the only way Austin knows how, and that's Stone Cold Steve Austin style.
Oh, that's gonna be bad. That's what's gonna happen at Unforgiven in 13 days unless somebody does step forward. Oh, man.
I hear what you're saying. But looking at these first few rows, I definitely say that it does matter if my pants get dropped.
You got that right. I'd get sick.
But if you're not out here because of Austin, then why are you out here, Rock?
Yeah, that is a good question. Why are you out here, Rock?
He's the WWF champion. I guess he can do whatever the heck he wants. He's the Rock, you know.
Yeah, but Foley was asking for the guy that ran over Stone Cold.
What are you, The Rock's mother?
Oh,
and The Rock just has to come out here and explain why he's out here to you, but he will. Seeing as you're the commissioner, The Rock is out here for one reason and one reason only, and that's payback.
Payback?
Uh-oh.
Nick, what do you mean payback?
Uh-oh.
And what The Rock is talking about is last Thursday night on SmackDown, on The Rock Show. The Rock still walked out WWF champion, but Kane chokeslam The Rock through the table. Now, whether it's one chokeslam, two, three, four, five, it doesn't matter to The Rock. It's how he did it. You see, Kane, The Rock understands that you've had a hard life growing up, a rough childhood. When you're a little kid, all little kids would come over to your house. Kane, come out and play. What'd you do? You came out.
Well, I'd like to come out and play with you, but the rage of fire is consuming my soul. And
oh, shut your mouth, you little punk.
Man, oh, man. Is that how Kane sounded when he was little? That's great.
You see, Kane, The Rock could care less whether or not it's your body on fire, your face on fire, liar, liar, your balls are on fire. The only...
The Rock is pumped up tonight.
Oh, the only thing that matters to The Rock is that you bring your candy ass to Unforgiven. You are the number one contender, and you just bring it. Bring it. Bring it to Unforgiven so The Rock can lay it to smack it down on your big red candy ass.
Great ball to fire, JR. This is great.
The Rock wants Kane, and he wants him.
Now, wait a minute.
Well, that's not Kane. That's the...
I know you're not stupid enough to let something like this happen. Please, The Rock and Kane, one-on-one for the WWF title? I don't think so.
Don't underestimate Foley's stupidity.
Fans chanting at the Rabid Wolverine.
The last time I checked, the WWF stands for World Wrestling Federation.
Yeah, that's right.
And not only am I the best damn wrestler in the company, I'm the best damn wrestler in the entire industry, period.
The best technical wrestler in the world, JR.
Can't argue that.
I've already beaten this joke of a champion once. If anyone deserves a title shot, it's me.
Well, he's got a point.
He sure does.
Okay, Benoit, I understand what you're saying. What you're saying is you think you ought to be the number one contender and not Kane.
Prove me wrong.
Yeah, prove him wrong, if you can.
Well, I tell you what I'm going to do. Uh-oh. He brings up a good point. I'm going to go back to my commissioner's table.
Oh, man!
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, boy!
I think business has picked up because there's the big red machine, the man that The Rock wants.
I hope that Kane didn't hear The Rock out here going,
Kane's the man that chokeslammed The Rock right through the announce table last Thursday night on SmackDown, and The Rock has not forgotten.
Uh-oh.
Now, since everybody's talking about number one contenders, let's don't forget about the old dead man.
All right, who can forget you?
Who can forget the American Badass when it comes to number one contenders?
Hey, wait a
second. Benoit in the ring.
Here we go.
The Rock, The Undertaker, and King. Oh, I'm getting it on.
I love it.
All four of these men are turning to each other.
No, Kane, no matter how you look at it, tonight, you and I have to function as a team, a tag team. regardless of who becomes number one contender, tonight is about you and I working together. Hey, I understand you don't play well with others. Maybe that started at an early age. Maybe you weren't the most well-liked on the playground. Maybe your report card read does not get along with others. Maybe you were the last one picked at kickball. But that doesn't matter, because tonight is about The Rock and Undertaker and us tearing them apart. Understand?
Benoit, I was never picked last.
What?
In kickball, I was never picked last.
No disqualification, here they come. That one during the commercial break.
Undertaker, what's up? Last time you and The Rock were tag team partners, The Rock had a double chair shot to the head. It's gonna happen like that again. The Rock could just as soon as go out there by himself. Now, we're not friends. We probably never ever will be friends. So you tell The Rock, tonight, how's it gonna be?
Let me tell you how it's gonna be. You're right. We ain't friends. But I'll be there for you. And when Foley, he announces the number one contender, I'm gonna be there for you then too.
It's next, no doubt. A reversal to the ball, an overhead suplex. The Rock with an overhead suplex. Taking over Benoit and taking him down.
Oh man, what a match.
Both these men are hurt, King. Both these men have paid the price.
The Undertaker wants the tag. The Rock needs to make the tag for the Undertaker.
He wants in there bad.
Kane wants the tag from the Wolverine. It's no disqualification. We are seeing a war.
The Rock is close to tagging. There's the tag.
The Undertaker got the tag.
Oh, my God, Benoit. You're in a world of trouble now.
Benoit never made the tag to Kane.
But they don't have to make a tag. It's no disqualification.
Oh. Undertaker. Taking Kane over the top.
Right out to him.
Oh, did you see that? Undertaker now taking over on Chris Benoit. The Rock and Kane running on the outside.
And look at Benoit. He's ready to go for what could be.
A touchdown. My God. A touchdown. The Undertaker took his touch. And Kane just ran the Rock's head right into our table.
What the heck? Look at this, Vic.
Undertaker's got a clip.
I believe he's going for the last round right here, JR.
No, no.
Kane with a clothesline.
Hey.
And velocity.
He got the Undertaker.
Jericho pinned the Undertaker with the help of the campaign. And the Rock's head bounced off our table. I don't think the Rock's even aware of it.
Rock, you lost.
We may have a winner and a loser, but I don't think this over, not by a long shot.
Well, what's the call, Mick?
You know what? I don't know what to think right now. I don't know. You know what? I'm saying all these men have been impressive. The only thing I can do as commissioner is make it a fatal four-way match at Unforgiven. All four men in the ring, the title up for grabs.
All of these guys are
Unforgiven?
That's the only thing I can think of at Unforgiven. The only thing that seems fair. The only thing that seems commissionary.
Here comes Kane. And we fall back in. The Undertaker was looking to hold the Rock. And the Rock was looking to hold the Undertaker.
I don't get it. Every one of these guys are going to get a shot at being the WWE champion. That was just saying at Unforgiven.
I'm saying I think that's the only fair thing. I think the WWE fans deserve and need to see all four of these men in the ring fighting it out for the richest sport. The richest pride of sport.
At Unforgiven, we got a fatal four-way for the WWE title. The Rock, Benoit, Kane, and the Undertaker. At Unforgiven in 13 days. Mick Foley will referee the Triple H Kurt Angle one-on-one matchup. At Unforgiven, we've got the tag team titles on the line. The Hardys beat the champions.
They're going to have to pull these four guys apart right now, Mick.
My God, this is chaotic.
I'm not sure there's enough guys to do the job. Sergeant Slaughter just went down.
Look at The Rock. He lands smack down on everybody.
Oh, hell is breaking loose here. We're going to go to Unforgiven. Just laid a smack down. Smack down on Benoit. Rock will take it.
Seeing as The Rock didn't say it on Monday night, he's saying it tonight. Finally, The Rock has come back to Phoenix.
I just love it when you mention their hometown.
is amazing.
Now, Mick Foley, The Rock will make this short and sweet. If you think that going into Unforgiven, The Rock is a targeted man, well, you're absolutely right. But if you think that The Rock isn't gonna make it to Unforgiven, you're wrong. Do you actually think that The Rock is gonna get taken out before Unforgiven and unable to defend his WWF title? Is that what you think?
It is a possibility, you know. Could happen.
Well, Mick Foley, with all due respect, The Rock wipes a lobster's left testicle with what you think.
Oh, boy. What, a lobster's left testicle?
The only thing that matters is that you get The Undertaker, get Kane, get Chris Benoit, and The Rock will do exactly what he does best, and that's lay it to smack it down on all their candy.
Yeah.
The Rock is all business facing the greatest challenge in his career 10 days away at Unforgiven.
Listen to what he's saying, Foley. Don't forget about that four-hole
match. Something you just said has me a little bit concerned, and that is lobsters don't have testicles, Rock.
What?
And I know because I have looked.
Oh, no.
Speaking of looking, I want you to look up there at some footage that I saw in the back on Monday night that concerns us all.
What's he talking about now?
Now, we're not friends. We probably never ever will be friends. So you tell The Rock. Tonight, how's it gonna be?
Let me tell you how it's gonna be. You're right. We ain't friends, but I'll be there for you. And when Foley, he announces the number one contender, I'm gonna be there for you then too.
Oh, that was strong.
Now, you saw it too, Rock. There is a look about The Undertaker, and I can't explain exactly what it is, but I know it scares the hell out of me, and I know it's the same look he had in June of 1998 when he threw me off the top of the Hell in the...
Uh-oh.
You know, Foley, I ain't the kind of guy that hides his feelings well. And just because me and The Rock, we ain't friends, that doesn't mean I'm gonna take him out.
Oh.
Just because me and Austin never seen eye to eye doesn't mean that I'm gonna mow him down with a car. But make no mistake about it. I am the kind of guy that gets what he wants. And what I want right now, you have.
Uh-oh. I knew it.
Wait.
I knew it.
Here
we go.
Take her, and you'll get a chance to get what he's got, but not until Unforgiven. At Unforgiven, you'll step in the ring with The Rock, and you feel free to battle for the richest prize in our sport.
Now what?
Hey, Foley, before you start rattling off your master plan, I can tell you that whatever it is, it's gonna suck.
Ha! Look, that tooth is still missing, like Foley's ear. It's gone.
Last Monday night, we had a tag team match. Rock and Undertaker against me and Kane. And what was the end of that match?
I remember.
Well, since you obviously have a very short memory, let me show you.
Oh, watch this, Michael.
Yeah, this is from Raw this past Monday night, Rock and The Undertaker against Chris Benoit and Kane.
That's it. Reverse jackknife. 1, 2, 3. That's right. It was me pinning Undertaker. And what was the reward for that match? A fatal four-way? Well, that's great, Mick. That makes a lot of sense.
He's got a point, you know, Michael.
But of all the participants in that match, I was the better wrestler. And either you, Undertaker, or Rock
can prove me wrong.
Oh, oh no!
Benoit, I'm not interested in proving you wrong. What I'm going to do is to all the people who call me inhuman, who call me a freak,
you've said that,
who call me a monster, I'm gonna prove them right.
Whoa!
Prove them right?
Okay, hold on, hold on, hold on. Now, all I've been trying to do out here is explain my plan. Now, if I may proceed without any interruptions.
Well, here comes Kane. That's one big interruption.
What I'd like to do is this.
Oh, boy.
I'd like to take the members.
What the heck? What is going on now? What the? Foley's lost it.
Undertaker, Rock, the two of you also will team up one more time right here in Phoenix, Arizona.
What a time for another cheap pop.
And you will be taking on the tag team of the Dudley Boys.
Oh my gosh!
And because there seems to be an awful lot of aggression here in this ring,
right,
I'm gonna make that match a table match.
Rock Undertaker versus the Dudleys in a table match.
If any of you refuse to work together as a team, and if there is anyone who decides to get physical with their partner during their match, that person is out of their match and unforgiven. That's the way it's going to be, and that, Kurt Angle, is final.
Triple H wants to tear Kurt Angle apart. The King tonight, The Rock and The Undertaker take on the Dudley Boys in a table match. Triple H and Kurt Angle must team together against TNA. And Kane and Chris Benoit meet the Acolytes in an Acolytes rules match. And hey, look out, Chris Benoit and The Rock coming out with Kane as well. And Kane and Chris Benoit double teaming the People's Champion, The Rock.
Well, Foley didn't say anything about this sort of contest
at all. Kane and Chris Benoit. These four men will meet in a fatal four-way in 10 days and Unforgiven.
We got a Phoenix four-way going right now. No, wait. There you go, Taker again.
Look at Kane stalking The Rock, King. Kane is stalking The Rock after The Undertaker made it one-on-one. The Rock's in trouble. The champion's in trouble.
Oh, no. Undertaker, look at this.
Choke slam to The Rock. Kane planted The Rock. Kane sending a message to the WWF Champion!
Can't touch him!
Undertaker, after everything that's happened now, clearly there's animosity between you and The Rock.
It's no secret. The Rock and I, we're just not friends. Hell, we don't even like each other. That's not gonna stop me tonight from being a professional and getting the job done with The Rock as my partner. But you know what? For The Rock's sake, he just better hope he doesn't piss me off.
Tension is clearly mounting between you and The Undertaker. Now, do you think you can trust him tonight as your tag team partner?
You know, you asked The Rock the question. Can The Rock trust The Undertaker? Well, The Undertaker comes out here and he shouldn't be worried about whether or not The Rock pissed him off. The Undertaker should be worried, though, at the simple fact that The Undertaker has already pissed off The Rock. So as far as for tonight's tag team match, The Rock has no problem with the match tonight. Because whether it's tonight, whether it's tomorrow, whether it's Unforgiven, The Rock has already made up his mind that he can't trust The Undertaker. The only person The Rock can trust is himself. The Rock can't trust The Undertaker, can't trust Kane, can't trust Benoit, can't trust his goof holding the camera, can't trust his chick looking and gawking at The Rock. The Rock can't even trust you, Lillian. Let The Rock ask you a question, Lillian. Do you like pie?
Yeah, I do.
Just like The Rock thought. If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Rock Undertaker versus the Dudleys. A table match on the way next. I knew it all along.
Yeah, but if I were The Rock, I don't think I'd want to face The Undertaker at Unforgiven. I might just punch him right here tonight.
The Rock never backs down from a challenge, you know that. And it's the biggest challenge of his career. Undertaker going for the choke slam. And The Rock ran into him inadvertently.
Once again, I think The Rock was thrown into him, wasn't he?
The Rock went for a rock bottom again, and Rock knocked over the top rope.
The biggest victory of the Dudley's career, King.
Oh, my gosh, look at this. Look at the look on Bubba. I don't know if he believes it. Well, King, let's take another look. Undertaker going for the chokeslam. Bubba Ray Dudley tossing The Rock into The Undertaker. But look at the look on The Undertaker's face. Did The Undertaker believe that The Rock ran into him on purpose? Well, Bubba Ray Dudley tossing The Rock outside the ring. It allowed the Dudley boys to pick up a huge upset over The Undertaker.
Green knee through the table. And the Dudley's win it. The biggest victory of the Dudley boys' career as The Undertaker struggles to his feet and The Rock does it well out here at ringside.
The Rock almost went through our announce table right here when he was thrown out of the ring. The Undertaker was pleading for The Rock to get back in the ring, but The Rock was out of it. There was no way he could.
Wait a minute! Choke slam through a table! The Undertaker choke slam The Rock through a table! What the? The Undertaker choke slam the WWF champion! If King, if that happens at Unforgiven, The Undertaker could be the new champion.
And I guess officially this match is over, so no, this match is for The Undertaker here, huh?
That's right, The Rock must face three men with his title on the line at Unforgiven. And Unforgiven is the biggest challenge of The Rock's career. The Rock is about to go through a living hell.
That people respond to losing in many different ways. Some respond well, while others respond very poorly. Undertaker, let's all take a look at what your response was.
Last Thursday night on SmackDown, a tag team table match, The Undertaker and The Rock versus the Dudleys.
I think The Undertaker thought that Rock did that intentionally.
That was a miscommunication, and that cost The Rock and The Undertaker the match. And then this, boom, the explosion.
Yeah.
That shocked us all.
That wasn't a miscommunication, JR. That wasn't unintentional either. I don't think The Rock enjoys looking at that footage.
Undertaker, The Rock has never liked you. He probably never will. But the fact of the matter is this, is that The Rock has always respected you. He's always respected you.
Strong words coming from The Rock, respect.
Now, Undertaker, The Rock understands if you were angry about going through the table on Thursday night. The Rock understands if you're angry that The Rock is a WWF champion and you're not.
Oh, the Undertaker's angry, all right.
But Undertaker, instead of chokeslamming The Rock through the table, if you wanted a shot at The Rock, all you had to do was ask. If you wanted a shot at The Rock's WWF title this Sunday night at Unforgiven, all you had to do was ask.
Just ask?
But Undertaker, seeing as you've already got your shot at Unforgiven, if you wanted a shot at The Rock's WWF title tonight.
Tonight? Uh-oh, wait a minute, JR.
Tonight? What's up with that?
All you have to do is ask.
Oh, my God.
You see what he's doing?
So, Undertaker, this is how The Rock is going to put it down. Undertaker, The Rock says you come on out here. And whether you come out as the American Badass, whether you come out as a Phenom, whether you come out as the Lord of Darkness or the Lord of Monkey Piss, it doesn't matter to The Rock.
My God. The Rock is irate at The Undertaker.
Lord of Monkey.
Easy.
Undertaker, the only thing that matters is that you come on out. And whether we do this now, an hour from now, 37 minutes from now, the fact of the matter is you come on out so The Rock can whip that candy ass all over Chicago.
You know, I'm standing back there, and I couldn't help but overhear you say how you respected The Undertaker. Let me remind you why you should respect The Undertaker. Because back when you were in high school, in the back seat of your daddy's car, trying to get some off of old Mary Jane Rotten Crutch.
What? Mary Jane?
I was humping these roads, and I was winning WWF titles. But you got to tell me, who in the hell are you to call me out? You know, there's just some people, they never learn. And I guess the people's champ never learns either.
Feel the tension here.
I told you Thursday night at SmackDown, don't piss me off.
Uh-oh. That's what he said, all right.
I remember it.
Then what do? You leave me hanging in the ring, and the Dudleys put me through the damn table.
That happened.
The Rock, that pissed me off. So you can stand out here, you can lift all the eyebrows you want, you can talk about all the monkey's nipples you want.
Monkey's nipples.
Hell, you can even fantasize about shoving things up people's asses. I don't give a damn. But you called me out, boy. I just hope that you can back up the smack your mouth spewing out.
This is gonna get ugly, JR.
He didn't call him Roy, he called him boy.
Because let me remind you something. Although I don't dress like Satan anymore, I'm still down with the devil, and I will go medieval on your ass. Just a second, before you two go to tearing each other apart before what I consider to be one of the most important pay-per-views in recent history, let me spell out the rules of the Fatal 4-Way at Unforgiven. You see, it's very simple. Four men enter the ring and they all wrestle at the same time. Whoever gets the pin wins. And whoever wins the match really wins because that person becomes the next WWF champion.
Yeah?
That means, Rock, you do not have to lose the match to lose the WWF Championship. Now, as far as the two of you tearing each other apart, if you thought I came out here to prevent that, you couldn't be more wrong.
What? He's gonna let him go at it?
What do you mean, Mick?
Undertaker, Rock, you want a part of each other, you got it. The Undertaker and The Rock, right here in Chicago, Illinois.
Tonight, I can't believe it.
If anyone deserves a shot at the title tonight, that would be me,
the world's greatest technical wrestler, and that's just the way it is.
Can't argue with that. Who's better?
The WWF title is going to be on the line, then I will be the one fighting for it, because there's no one standing in the ring or anyone in the back that can prove me wrong. I'm the one who deserves a shot at the title tonight.
He's got a point. Oh, my God. Nobody in the back.
What makes you think you deserve The Rock? What makes you think you deserve the WWF title? I deserve a title shot, and I'm the only one who does. Rock, you're mine.
What makes Kane talk so good all of a sudden?
Wait a minute.
I didn't say anything about a title shot. The Rock did. Now, The Rock is capable of many things. He is capable of electrifying a crowd.
No doubt about that.
He is capable of creating a catchphrase that I can steal.
And no doubt about that.
Hell, The Rock is even capable of wearing that shirt and getting away with it.
It's fuzzy.
But The Rock is not capable of making a title shot. I am. The title will be on the line at Unforgiven. But seeing as how you two want a piece of each other so bad, I'm saying tonight the two of you will go man to man in this very ring.
Benoit, Kane?
So that's the way it's going to be. Benoit versus Kane, and The Undertaker versus The Rock.
Here tonight,
two main events.
That's technical wrestling for you. Well, I was going to be watching this match very closely for another reason. Wow! How does this make you feel when this guy comes out the Rock and the roof comes off of the building?
Tell you what, when The Rock says just bring it, he means it. Once he's turned on, it's hard to turn him off. That is, of course, until he ends up in the crossface.
This one could be a slobber knocker here. There's no title on the line. It's personal. All as a result of The Undertaker dropping The Rock through a table last Thursday night. Thursday night on SmackDown was big for these two. And The Undertaker overpowering The Rock in the collar and elbow tie-up. Big time right to left to the head and body.
Well, let me just ask you this, Darren. What's wrong with this picture? You got Chris Benoit sitting here cool, calm, and collected, viewing his two opponents for this coming Sunday beat the living hell out of each other.
There's a cover, lateral press, and The Rock able to kick out.
This can only work in your favor, Chris.
Let them beat the hell out of each other, because come this Sunday, it'll be easy pickings for the Wolverine.
Right.
Well, I don't know about that, but in any event, it's going to be a war in my estimation. No pay-per-view has been more aptly named than Unforgiven this Sunday. Philadelphia sold out in 2 hours. The fans in Philly will be jacked up this Sunday on pay-per-view.
And the fatal four-way rules, Chris. All four of you men will be in the ring at the same time. You don't even have to beat The Rock. You can pin The Undertaker, you can pin Kane, and you still become the WWF champion.
Any pinning combination can walk out as a WWF champion. Uh-oh. That's all that matters.
The Rock does have to be involved in the decision to lose the title. Good, bad, or indifferent, that's the way it is. And a big time right hand, a thunderous right by the American badass. And The Rock been introducing those steps up close and personally.
Every bit of damage these two guys do to each other is just working in the favor of Ben Watson here.
And Kane.
Well, of course, Kane, he's back there lurking somewhere.
Well, I took care of Kane earlier on in the show.
Yeah, but now, don't get upset, but you did have to whack him with a chair.
Yeah, right on the back of the head, and Kane then got up and Rock, and Rock may not get up after this attack. Rock being... Undertaker looking for the Rock's head, but he found the ring post and may have cracked his right hand.
Oh, that's it. What are you going to do, Chris, if these guys come over here on up?
Look out.
Yeah, boy, here we go.
Laying the smackdown on the Undertaker.
No, wait!
And a low blow by the Rock.
Look at that, Chris.
Is that what he has to resort to? Is that what the Rock is about?
The Rock with the right hand going below the belt on the Undertaker.
That's not exactly technical wrestling, is it?
I think these two men respect each other, but we know they said it. They don't like each other.
What about respect, Chris? Do you respect either one of these guys?
Respect, they're going to find out this coming Sunday at the Wolverine.
Referee knocked down.
No respect.
No respect for any of them. Did you hear that, JR?
Oh, man, look at that. What a flying DDT by the 330-pounder. Down is the Rock. There's one, two, three. And the referee down, bad break for the Undertaker.
You got to admit, Benoit, that was a pretty good technical DDT there.
And that may come back to haunt the Undertaker before it's all said and done in this matchup.
Wow.
Another straight right hand by the Undertaker. Both these men, this has been a fight. Not a wrestling match. Spine buster by the WWE champion.
Chris, look at this.
There's the ref. The ref's got to get up.
But look, it's the people's elbow. What do you do to combat this, Chris?
The Rock with the elbow. The Rock with the cover. The referee is still down.
Where's the ref?
Where's the ref? Where's the ref?
Referee's still knocked down. If he hadn't, you got to believe that the Rock would have already pinned, or the Undertaker would have pinned the Rock earlier.
Hell up, Hubner.
Wait a minute. Chris, I want to ask you, could you withstand a people elbow on this?
Toe slam! Toe slam! That's got to be all! Referee's movements are the count. This one is over. And the Rock's kicked out of the toe slam. I don't believe it.
How close was that?
I've never seen anyone kick out of that.
Somehow, some way, the Rock got a shoulder up.
Uh-oh.
And that's it. Rock looking for the Rock bottom. Undertaker,
no. Nobody will kick out of this. Last ride from the Undertaker.
The last ride. Undertaker got the last ride on the Rock. And the Undertaker defeated the Rock with the last ride. Riding in the Forgiven with all the momentum in the world.
Well said, well said. The last ride. Rock's last ride. Because after this coming Sunday, the Wolverine will be walking out WWF champion. That's all that matters.
It's going to be the most emotionally charged pay-per-view, perhaps in the history of the WWF. The return of Stone Cold Steve Austin this Sunday. Triple H and Kurt Angle, one-on-one. And now this, the fatal four-way.
Boy, look at this. The last ride. I can't believe my eyes. The Undertaker. Right in the middle of the ring, 1-2-3, winner over the Rock.
The Undertaker on this night, dominating the WWF champion. That's bigger than dominating.
I took care of him earlier.
I don't think you did there, Chris.
Boy, it's been a great ride.
What the hell is he doing down here?
It's been a great ride here on USA, and it ain't over yet, is it? Look at this.
You got no damn business being down here.
Oh, why don't you go suggest that to him?
Wait a minute, he ain't coming over here.
It's time to prove some people wrong.
Wait, where's Benoit going?
Benoit going in the ring.
Look at the Undertaker.
And Benoit from behind, naming the Undertaker. And here comes Kane now. It's going to be Kane and Benoit. They were enemies earlier. They'll be enemies Sunday. They're enemies now, but they're joining forces.
They're definitely on the same page against the Undertaker.
Joining forces against the Undertaker. And now the American Badass is trying to fight back.
But he's too much. There's too much. How can he fight back against Kane and Benoit?
The Undertaker just has shocked us with a huge victory over the Rock. And now the Undertaker.
nothing loose. The return of Stone Cold, Steve Austin, and the Fatal 4-Way. The WWE title has never been contested in a bigger match. It's a extravaganza. It's pay-per-view. Pay-per-view Sunday.
Just who the hell ran over Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Somebody should step forward now, please.
And because nobody feels like stepping up to the plate and saying, okay, I did it, the commissioner of the World Wrestling Federation has decided to make a couple of predictions.
Predictions?
You see, I thought about just who had the most to gain by running down Stone Cold last November, and hey, I know that my first candidate, this may not be the most popular thing to ever come out of my mouth, but at the time of Stone Cold's accident, there were two really, really big stars in the WWF running neck and neck for popularity.
First of all, it wasn't an accident.
Since Stone Cold went down, one of these superstars saw his t-shirt sales go through the roof.
Uh-oh.
Saw his popularity go through the roof. Saw his ability to electrify crowds go through the roof.
Could it be?
And I hate to say it, but one of those suspects is a former tag team partner of mine. And that, unfortunately, would be you, Rock.
Mick Foley pointed at the Rock King, considering him a prime suspect.
He did have a lot to gain. I mean, you know, let's face it. I mean, it was the Rock's rental car.
But didn't the Rock just a week ago, King, on Raw, deny having anything to do with it?
Everybody's denied it. Is there one person out here that stepped forward? So in other words, everybody is denying it, along with the Rock.
Well, the Rock cannot be pleased.
Out of respect for everything you've done, out of respect for our friendship, I'm going to give you a chance in front of all these people to explain your actions or your inactions last November.
Oh boy, here we go. This is like being put under that hot light. Well, the Rock's on the spot here, King, and you have to believe the Texas Rattlesnake is watching this at home in the Lone Star State. Here we go.
Mick Foley. It seems to The Rock that he's feeling a little, how do you say, deja vu?
That's how you say it.
Because see, The Rock has already answered this time and time again. The Rock has already told you that he didn't do it. The Rock has already told the cops that he didn't do it. The Rock has told Stone Cold Steve Austin himself that he didn't do it.
He said he didn't do it.
He's emphatic, King.
Now, Mick Foley, as a best-selling author, it seems like you have a little problem understanding the English language.
Yeah, among other things.
So for your own benefit, let The Rock tell you one more time in plain, simple English. The Rock did not run over Stone Cold.
Adamant about that, King.
What about a polygraph test?
Now, for further clarification, let The Rock tell you in another language. Let him tell you in Swedish.
What? Swedish?
The Rock didn't run over Stone Cold on the
What? That's Swedish. You don't understand Swedish? You're not bilingual?
I don't think Foley is either, though.
Stone Cold, and who did? Who's going to step forward?
Now, Mick, if you need even further clarification, let The Rock tell you in Chinese.
Uh-oh. Chinese?
Ching bang ding dong, hit Stone Cold, ai!
I think he just ordered some chicken chow mein.
You see, Mick Foley, it doesn't matter what language The Rock tells you in, because whether it happened then or it didn't happen, regardless of what happened to Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock would still be standing before you today, the WWF champion.
Wow. That's a pretty strong statement.
Very strong.
If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Mick, this is completely unfair.
Right. Her parents paid a lot of money to send her to the best driving school
You've
in Connecticut.
You've seen the footage? You know that me, my brother, my father, and the man that I defeated in the center of the ring Monday night, my ex-fiancé, Test, we were all there on the scene when Austin was being loaded into the ambulance.
That's right. I remember that.
There's no way we could have done it. We weren't even there. But I'll tell you who I do think did it. And that's someone that you would never suspect. Someone who wasn't even here the night Austin was mowed down. And there's only one person with a heart that's dark and twisted enough, who's remorseless, and there's only one person that fits that description. And that's the man who once abducted me.
Uh-oh. Oh, no.
The Undertaker.
Oh. Stephanie is accusing The Undertaker of running over Stone Cold.
Come on, it could be The Undertaker. He's heartless. He does have a black heart. You know he does.
Well, she makes a point. Undertaker was not involved in Survivor Series, King.
And he had a lot to gain by eliminating Stone Cold. Uh-oh.
Undertaker, she brings up a couple of valid points, and what I want to know is this true?
Is it true? Ugh.
It's true.
What?
What?
It's true?
It's what?
She is a sleazy tramp.
Oh, boy!
Is that what he means is just true?
Yeah, I think so.
Wasn't exactly a...
Oh, look at Kurt Angle from behind. Emotions are running high here, King. And Triple H with Angle. And all hell is breaking loose in the ring. Look at Jericho. He just attacked that cut. Kurt Angle apparently cutting the eaters. His friend Stephanie King. And Triple H has got Kurt Angle in the corner. Hammering away.
Oh, this is getting completely out of hand.
The investigation is erupted. Oh, now Undertaker with Kurt Angle. Okay, I'll tell you, a lot of blame being tossed around out here. A lot of finger pointing. Tensions are running high.
Please, somebody step forward.
Officials, referees, the commissioner trying to keep things under control.
Well, Foley's lost complete control of this. I'm worried this is going to mean that Stone Cold Steve Austin is going to have to conduct the investigation himself.
And Unforgiven in 3 days. All hell is broken loose here. Commissioner Mick Foley, King. Oh, you gotta believe fines are gonna be handed out in this. I'll tell you, if it wasn't for the commissioner, there would have been a major explosion right here. But we're gonna have an explosion in the ring later on tonight, King. The Rock, Undertaker, and Triple H teaming up to take on Kurt Angle, Kane, and Chris Benoit.
What a night this is gonna be on SmackDown.
Oh, breaks up the three count. Oh, what a shot to The Rock.
Stephanie McMahon Helmsley, Monday Night on Raw, trying to get this. Oh, it's called off for the husband. Oh, look at the Rock. Playing the SmackDown on Benoit. The Rock just tipped in to the SmackDown Hotel. And the Rock and Benoit outside the ring. Going at one another, bouncing off the steel steps in Benoit's face. The Rock and Benoit part of the fatal four-way matchup. And Unforgiven on Sunday. And look out, Benoit counted. And Triple H now. He wants the time for Triple H.
Triple H needs to make a tag to the Undertaker.
There's the Rock. He's been double-teamed by both angles. Above Benoit and Kane.
A Brahma Bull in a serious state. Benoit and Kane with a double team. And look out. The Undertaker. The Undertaker.
The Undertaker's coming. The Undertaker's helping the Rock. The Undertaker beat the Rock Monday, but he's helping him here tonight on SmackDown.
The Undertaker reading the odds against Kane and Chris Benoit. Officials trying to break this mess up.
My God, this is chaotic. Look at the carnage. The Rock is down, and how badly is the champion hurt?
I can guarantee you the Undertaker won't be helping the Rock Sunday at Unforgiven.
But the Undertaker here tonight on SmackDown did the right thing. But wait a minute. This match is still underway with Angle and Triple H in the ring. And
what's Undertaker doing?
The Undertaker trying to run over the Rock, and the Rock barely rolled out of the way.
I can't believe that, JR, but meanwhile, back in the ring, Kurt Angle and Triple H are still going at it.